So, good morning, students. This is the first class after your summer vacations, and I hope your summer vacation was very good. You enjoyed well in your summer vacations. Now, students, it's time to study. So, whatever videos, whatever homework we are uploading on Ursal for you all, you must watch these videos. You must submit your work on time. So, be attentive and be focused for your studies. Okay? Okay. Let's start with exercise 2.5. And this these two exercises were left earlier, so I'm just completing these two exercises. So the first question is of your exercises, and the topic is reducing equations to simpler form. So first you need to you have an equation, you need to convert into simplest form. How? I'll explain you. Now let's take the first question of your exercise 2.5, and the question number one is, question one of your exercises, x divided by 2 minus 1 upon 5 is equals to x upon 3 plus 1 upon 4. Okay, students, first you need to club the variable terms on one side and the constant terms on the other side. For that, x by 2 as it is on the LHS, and I just transpose this x by 3 to the LHS. X by 3, here it is positive, but after transposing to LHS the sign get opposite, right? Similarly, 1 by 4 as it is on the RHS, I just need to transpose this 1 by 5 to the RHS, so the sign get opposite. In LHS it has negative sign, but after transposing to RHS the sign get changed to positive. Now solve LHS and RHS. The LCM of 2 and 3 will be 6. So 2 3s are 6 into numerator. Similarly, 3 2s are 6 multiplied by the numerator, which is x. Similarly, you need to take the LCM of 4 and 5. And as you know that 4 and 5, the LCM is 20. So 4 5s are 20 multiplied by 1, which is the numerator. 5 4s are 20 multiplied by 1, which is the numerator. 3x minus 2x will give you 1x divided by 6. This is 5 plus 4 divided by 20. Now, x divided by 6, this is equals to 5 plus 4, this is 9 divided by 20. Now, you just need to cross multiply 6 for getting the value of x. Now, the value of x will be, x is equals to 6 into 9 divided by 20. 2 3s are 6, 2 10s are 20. So the answer is 9 3s are 27 divided by 10. So this is your answer. So you have an equation in x, right? And you convert this equation to the simplest form. The simplest form is 22 upon 7. So the value of x is 22 upon 7. If you put this value 22 upon 7 here in place of x, you will get same value in LHS and in RHS. So LHS equals to RHS, you will get LHS equals to RHS when you put this value x in this polynomial. Okay, so please write down this question, note down this solution fast. Now the third question is, x plus 7 divided by 1 minus 8x divided by 3. In the LHS and in RHS, you have 17 by 6 minus 5x by 2. Second question is for your homework, okay? Now, first you need to take the LCM of this. Okay, before that, you can write x plus 7 separately minus 8x divided by 3. 17 divided by 6 minus 5x divided by 2. Again, you need to club the constant terms in the one side and variables on the other side. So the variable terms are, here the variable terms are, this is my variable term, this is my variable term, and this is my variable term, and the rest are my constant terms, right? So what I'll do, x divided by 1 minus 8x divided by 3 and plus 5x divided by 2. 17 divided by 6 on the RHS and minus 7 divided by 1. I hope this up to this point, the things are clear to you all, right? If any student has any sort of doubt, he or she can ask me in the later sessions, okay? So, now you need to take the LCM of 1, 2 and 3. So, the LCM of 1, 2 and 3 will be equals to 6, right? So, the LCM is 6. So, 1, 6, 6 multiply by numerator, which is x. 3, 2, 6 multiply by numerator, which is 8x. 2, 3, 6 multiply by numerator, which is 5x is equals to. Now, here the LCM of 6 and 1 is equals to 6, right? So, 6, 1, 6 into 17, which is the numerator. 1, 6, 6 into 7, which is the numerator. I think up to this point, all the steps are clear to you all, right? Now, 6x minus 8 to the 16x plus 5 3 is a 15x divided by 6. This is 17 minus 6 7 is a 42 divided by 6. Now, this is 6x, this is 15x, this will give you 21x minus 16x divided by 6, right? Is equals to, now, this is 17, this is minus 42, so this will give you minus 5, 12 minus 7, 5, 3 minus 1, 2 divided by 6, right? Now, 21 minus 16 will give you 5x, right, divided by 6 is equals to minus 25 divided by 6. You just need to cross multiply these values. You will get x is equals to 6 into minus 25 divided by 6 into 5. So 5 5s are 25. So the value of x will be minus 5. So this is the simplest form. So in this way, you have just converted this equation, given equation into the simplest form. So the answer is x is equals to minus 5. So note it down first. So first you separate out the constant values and the variables. Then club all the variables on the one side and constant values on the other side like this. Like you have club this variable term in the LHS, this term in the LHS, and this term you just transpose from RHS to the LHS, right? Similarly, you just you have clubbed these constant values on the RHS. Then you need to solve for x and you will get the value of x. X is equals to minus 5. This is the simplest answer. Okay. Note it down first, then I'll take the another question. Now the next question is question number 6, which is equals to m minus 1 divided by 2 is equals to 1 minus m minus 2 divided by 3. The question that I'm leaving intentionally are all for your homework. So just try those questions. If you find any difficulty while solving those questions, you can ask me. Don't worry, okay? So this is the question. Now, again, first you need to solve for variables and separate out variables on the one side and constant terms on the other side, okay? Like m divided by 1. Minus. So first I separate out these values. M by 2 minus 1 by 2 is equals to 1 minus M by 3 minus 2 by 3, right? Now in the third step, I just multiply this negative sign within the bracket. Okay, now minus plus minus, so I'll get M by 2 minus minus plus, so I'll get 1 by 2. Now here is 1 minus plus minus, which is m by 3 minus minus plus, which is 2 by 3. Again, I need to club these variables on the one side. I have this variable term, this variable term, this term is variable, and these terms are constants, right? Now, what I'll do now? So, m by 1 minus m by 2, this term I need to transpose on the LHS, 1 as it is plus 2 by 3 as it is, and I just transpose half from the LHS to RHS with a negative sign, right? Now take LCM of 1, 2 and 3. Similarly, you need to take LCM of 1, 2 and 3. So the LCM is 6. I hope this thing is clear to you that how to get LCM of 1, 2 and 3, right? So 1, 2 and 3. When you take the LCM of these two, 1 ones are 1, 2, 3. 2 ones are 2, 3 as it is. 3 ones are 3, right? So 1, 2s are 2, 3s are 6. So the LCM of 1, 2 and 3 is equals to 6. I hope this thing is clear to you all, right? Okay. Now, so the LCM of 1, 2 and 3 is 6. So 1, 6 are 6 into numerator. 2, 3s are 6 into numerator. 3, 2s are 6 into numerator, right? Similarly, 1, 6 are 6. 3, 2s are 6. 2, 2s are 4. 2, 3s are 6. 3, 1s are 3, right? Now, 6 plus 2, 8m minus 3m divided by 6. 6 plus 4, 10 minus 3 divided by 6. Now, the rest part I am doing here. So, 8 minus 3 is equals to 5m divided by 6. 10 minus 3 is 7 divided by 6. Just need to cross multiply these value and you will get the value of m. 6 into m, so the answer is 7 upon 5, or you can say the value of m is 7 upon 5. So this is the simplest form. So you have converted this equation to the simplest form, m is equals to 7 by 2, or you can say that you have solved this equation for value of m. Okay, note it down first. Okay, now the next question is question number 8. Now, how to solve this question? This question you need to simplify and solve. First, you need to simplify and then you need to solve for value of x, for value of y. Okay, or whatever maybe the variable is. Now, how to multiply these two values? 15 into y, 15y minus 15 into 4. Then you just multiply 2 with y minus minus plus 2 into 9 plus 5 multiply by y plus 5 multiply by 6 is equals to 0. So this will give you 15y minus 16, right? Minus 2y plus 18 plus 5y plus 30 is equals to 0. Okay, now take the variable term or you need to club the variable terms on one side and the constant terms on the other side. So variable terms that I have in this expression is this one, this one, this one. These three are the variable terms and these three are the constant terms. So it's better to move these constant terms to the RHS. Okay. Now, this is 15y, this is 5y. So, 15 plus 5 is, okay, I'll write 15y plus 5y minus 2y on the LHS and constant terms on the RHS. So, 60 when I transpose to the RHS with opposite sign, right, plus 60. Similarly, minus 18, similarly, minus 30, right? Now, 15 plus 5 is 20, 20 minus 2 is 18y. Now, 60 minus, this is equals to 48, right? 3 plus 1, 4, and 8 plus 0 is 8, right? So I can write 18y is equals to 12, or I can write y is equals to 12 divided by 18. So 6 3s are 18 and 6 2s are 12. So the answer that I got is value of y is 2 divided by 3. This is my answer. Okay, so in this way, first you simplify this expression and then you solve the value for y. Note it down first. Okay, so exercise 2.5 is over. Some of the questions I have intentionally left for you all. so that you can practice those questions. And if you find any difficulty while solving those questions, you people are free to ask me in any other Zoom session or any other session, okay? But do try those questions, okay? Take seriously your studies, students. I just request you all, okay? Now, I'm starting with the exercise 2.6, and the very first question is question number 4. Though it is same as that of, I mean the concept of these questions same as that of question exercise 2.5. Okay, same, you need to simplify this question and then you need to solve for value of y. Okay, so that's why I've just taken question number 4. Question number 1, 2 and 3 are very easy question, okay? So I'm just taking question number 4 and next question number 5th, okay? Now, first solve these equations by just cross multiplying these two values. So cross multiplication, or you can simply write cross multiplication. Now I can write 5 3y plus 4 is equals to minus 2 minus 6y, right? Now then I just need to multiply these values, right? And I hope you remember how to multiply a monomial with a binomial, right? Now if not, I'll explain you later. 5 3s are 15y, 5 4s are 20. Minus 2 into 2 will give you minus 4, minus minus plus 6 2s are 12y, right? Now, this is 15y, this is 12y, so you just need to club the variables first. So, 15y as it is, and I just transpose this 12y in LHS with a negative sign, right? Now, similarly, minus 4 as it is, and I just need to transpose this 20 plus 20 from LHS to the RHS with a negative sign. Now, 15 minus 12 will give you 3y, right? And this is equals to minus 24. Now, y is equals to minus 24 divided by 3, and you know 3 8s are 24, so the value of y is equals to minus 8. So this is the answer. So first you simplify this equation by cross multiplying the values of numerator and denominator, then you solve for value of y, for the variable y, and the value is y equals to minus 8. I hope everything is clear to you all. If not, you can ask me in the later sessions. Please note it down first. Okay students, now take question number 5th. Again, you need to cross multiply first these values. So you will write cross multiplication. So I can write 3 multiply by 7y plus 4, and minus 4 got multiplied with y plus 2. What I'll get? 7 3s are 21y and 3 4s are 12, right? Similarly, minus 4 into y will give you minus 4y, and minus 4 multiply with 2 will give you minus 8, 4 2s are 8 with a negative sign, right? Minus plus minus, minus plus minus, plus plus plus. Now, club variables one side to the one side, so plus 4y, then this is minus 12 minus 8, right? So 21 plus 4 will give you 25y, and this is equals to minus 20, right? Minus 12 minus 8 is equals to minus 20. Now you can calculate the value for y is minus 20 divided by 25. So 5 5s are 25 and 5 4s are 20. So the value of y is equals to minus 4 divided by 5. Okay, so note it down first, and if you have any problem, you can ask me, okay? So okay students, now the last question for the day is, the ages of Hari and Harry are in the ratio 5 is to 7, right? So the ratio is given of Hari and Harry's present age, right? If nothing is given, that means this is the ratio of their present ages. Now, 4 years from now, that means after 4 years. 4 years from now means after 4 years, 4 saal baad, right? 4 years from now, the ratio of their age will be 3 is to 4, okay? So find their present age. So you need to calculate the present age of Hari and Harry. Now, first let the present age of present ages of Hari and Harry be 5K and 7K, okay? 5K and 7K. Now, 4 years from now means 4 years from now means after 4 years. That means after 4 years. Or you can say after 4 years from now. After 4 years means plus 4. Okay. That means plus 4. You will add 4 years in both the ages of Hari and Harry, right? Like, so the present age of, so you will write, age of Hari after 4 years and age of Harry after 4 years. Okay. So the present age of Hari is 5K. So after 4 years, 4 years will be added to the age of Hari. Similarly, I need to add 4 years in the age of Harry, because he is talking about after 4 years. Now the ratio of these two ages is 3:4. Now the condition is given to you that 5k plus 4 divided by 7k plus 4 is equals to 3/4. Is this visible on the screen? Now you just need to cross multiply the values. So we will write 4 into 5k plus 4, 3, 7k plus 4, 4 5s are 20k, 4 4s are 16, 3 7s are 21k and 4 3s are 12. Right? How you multiply these values? 4 with 5 and 4 with 4, 3 with 7 and 3 with 4. So 4 5s are 20, 4 4s are 16, 3 7s are 21 and 4 3s are 12. Now club the variables together, like 20k and 21k. So you can write, I'll solve the rest part here. So this is 16. So I can write 16 minus 12 is equals to 21k minus 20k, right? So this is 4 is equals to 1k, or I can simply write the value of k is equals to 4. So this is the value of k. Okay, so as soon as I get the value of k, I can get the value of present age of Hari and Harry. How? Just by multiplying this k with 5 and 7. So what I'll write? I'll write present age of Hari, which is equals to 5k. So 5 into 4, 5 4s are 20 years. So the present age of Hari is 20 years. Similarly, present age of Harry is equals to 7k, right? 7k. So when you multiply 7 with 4, you will get 28 years. So the required answer is 20 years and 28 years. I hope this thing is clear to you, all right? So please note it down fast. This is the last question for the day. Note it down fast, then I'll explain you once more how to solve this question. And student, question number 7 is for your homework. Okay? Okay. Now the question says is, the age of Hari and Harry are in the ratio 5:7. That means you can say Hari's present age is 5k and you can say Harry's present age is 7k. Okay, then after 4 years you need to add plus 4. You need to add 4 with their present age. So the present age of Hari is 5k. So after 4 years his age will be 5k plus 4. Similarly, after 4 years Harry's age will be 7k plus 4, right? Then a condition is given to you that after 4 years the ratio of their age will be 3:4. So 3:4.
Now you just need to cross multiply the values, solve for k. As soon as you get the value of k, you just need to put the value of k in 5k and 7k, and you will get the present ages of Harry and Hari. Okay, so students, I just request you watch these videos that we are uploaded on Ursel, because these videos are for you, not for us. Okay, and submit your work on time. Okay, and if you have any problem, you can ask me. Okay, students. So thank you, students.